I was planning to make another video this week, but I made a stupid mistake in my last video that needs addressing first. I was convinced that my test PC had PCI Express 3.0 slots, while in fact, the Fenvi 2 machine only has PCI Express 2.0 slots. So the test results from the NVMe adapters showed PCI Express 2.0 performance instead. Oops, sorry. That's why today, I'm upgrading my test PC again. It's the Anarchy with me on the XIG guy. This mainboard I picked up nearby has an Intel Core i5-7600K CPU. Uses DDR4, which it was happy to sell me as well, and should have a PCI Express 3.0 slot. It didn't come with a cooler, but my father-in-law gave me this less than a week ago. When I looked at the box, he chuckled and said, "Don't get too excited, it's just a cooler." Little did we know that today I would need one. It's for an i7 of an earlier generation, but it should fit this i5. Right, let's see if it turns on first. Oh yeah! Oh, oops. I connected the GPU fan to the case fan header. That was an issue though. It booted straight into the BIOS setup and would turn off directly after saving the settings. I figured it might be the power supply, so I grabbed another one, but it didn't change things. I noticed the date kept being set back to 2009, which by the way is interesting on a 2018 BIOS, so I changed the battery, but that didn't help either. At last I thought, maybe it just wants something to boot? So I plugged in my Ventoy stick and it works. Never seen that happen before. Usually you'll get a message on screen saying booting failed, but okay, I'll take it. So I added the first card that I tested last time, the GLOTRENDS card I got from Amazon. Last time I tested this one, we got 1.6 GB a second read rate and 1.2 GB a second write rate. Let's fire up GNOME disks again and retest. Why is it so slow? Why is it even slower than before? To check if the drive was still good, I plugged it back into my Fenvi 2 machine. Still fine here. But the... Plugged it back onto my new mainboard again and now it's suddenly way faster. Okay, let's not overthink this and go on with the tests. So it's about twice as fast as it was on PCIe 2.0. That was to be expected, but still cool to see this confirmed. Next, I plugged in the cheap X1 card from AliExpress. On PCIe 2.0, we reached just shy of 400 MB a second both read and write speed. On PCIe 3.0, we see the read speed more than doubled and the write speed about twice the old number. So the X1 card on 3.0 actually is a bit faster than SATA. Just not that much though. So how does it do in an actual X1 slot? Well, that depends on the speed of the slot. Slots often have mixed speeds, so it could very well be that the X1 slots are not PCIe 3.0 but only 2.0. Which indeed seems to be the case here. I tried the other slot as well, but it didn't make a difference. Now the Jeyi adapter, the one that came with the heatsink. Without the heatsink, it now gets capped at 3.4 GB a second read and 2 GB a second write rates. Indeed, the exact same number as the GLOTRENDS adapter. You might have noticed that this motherboard is equipped with an actual M.2 slot. On Medium's website, they state it's for SATA SSDs, but let's try it anyway. Secure it nicely with a way too big thumbscrew. Nothing. So I guess that's not an option. How about that heatsink? Let's put it on and see what happens. Yeah, the same. I guess this is the upper limit on PCI Express 3.0. The heatsink might help with longevity though. Some people asked about booting, which is something I still have to figure out myself. Let's just install Fedora on the NVMe to see if it works on this machine. If it doesn't, on Linux just make sure your bootloader and kernel, say your /boot partition, are on another drive. That can be anything from an old hard drive, a SATA SSD, a thumb drive, anything that your system can boot from. For Windows, something like Clover might help, but I haven't gotten around to testing that myself. Some people also mention modding the BIOS to fix this, but I haven't tried it myself yet and I don't know how safe this option is. Anyway, let's see if this one boots. Yes, it does. So as expected, booting from one of these will work perfectly fine as long as your BIOS understands what to do with it. That's all I have for you today. I hope you liked this video. Sorry for the error in the last one. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.